Today we are going to learn Schneider PLC.
So, first thing first, just open the Schneider Eco-Structure Machine Expert Basic and go for the application protection. I'm making it both inactive. I don't have any read and write protection. There is no password I'm using. And hit apply. And there we get the properties done and go for the configuration next. I'm using a normal PLC, any PLC I can choose from the list from right here, and the IO modules, analog, digital, and the modules, all that I can add from here. It's totally upon what thing you are using. And next, I'm going to the configuration for the IO input and output. First thing first, have to double tap on the digital inputs right here. You can see the digital inputs are I0.0, I0.1. This is the type of input addressing, and then go to the hit the digital outputs. You can see it will be %Q 0.0, 0.1, 0.2, like that. This is the input and output addressing. This is the configuration, and we can go hit the programming. Now I just hit the programming, and I'm going to show you how to place the input and output and how to go to online in the simulation mode. So here I have the NO contact. I'm just placing an NO contact right here, and I'm going to place an output coil right here, and that will be automatically drawn. If you want to erase it, you have to use the erase lines and draw the lines using a pencil, and you have to go for the input addressing for the %I. By typing the I, you'll be getting the sessions I0.0. I'm using the first address, and you can go for the output address %Q and getting the session as Q0.0. That's it. And let's see how we are going to the simulation. First, we have to compile this program. Come for compiling, for checking the errors, like that. We are using the compile option and go hit the launch simulator. Now we are going up to the simulator and we are going to run it. So I have to hit allow access for the first time, M221 simulator, and then have to go to start the controller from here. And okay, now we are at the run mode. This is my simulation window, and I have to hit the I0.0 on for getting my Q0.0 first digital in and out, on and off. So I'm going to hit the I0.0 here. By clicking here, you'll be getting the output here, and you can see the green symbol on the right side also. That's a on and off control in the Schneider. So I'm getting back to the edit mode by clicking the stop simulation. Now we are back to the edit mode, and then just clearing all this stuff. Before that, have to use the first thing first, I'm going to use the timers. From here, I'm getting the function blocks. I'm going to the timers. The first thing is the timer, and I'm placing my timer right here, and just place and click here. So you can see by placing your cursor here, you have to choose which time you're using. That could be a T on, T off, and a pulse divergence, TP. And you can go to hit the preset and the time base also. I'm using the time base as 1 second, and the preset value is 10. So I'll be getting the 10 second on delay timing. And if you want to make it retentive, you can do it also and hit apply. So I'm getting to launch the simulator right here, and you can see I'm going to the runtime and have to start the controller from the top right here. I have to start my controller, and if you want to get my watch time or watch table, have to go to the animation table and add a new animation table, and have to add the percent for watching the timer timing TM0%TM0V, that is the preset time, and add to my watch list, that is my preset value, and have to run the controller I0.0, that is the contact that will be powering the timer. And you can see the timer is start running. 1, 2, 3, 4, my preset is 10 seconds. So after 10 seconds I'll be getting my own delay right here. So that is the first thing to learn about timers. And if you want to go to the back side on have to de-edit the timer, you can go hit it as an off timer. This is my off timer. I just made it as my off timer, and also I'm making it as a return date. Okay, I'm not making it as a return date this time, so I'm changing to on timer again and making it as a return date. I'll show you what is retention, and on the runtime you can see what is retention, and see, you can see on the runtime. And enable this contact, and you can see the timer will be running as 1, 2, and you can see what's here. While I'm pressing the off button during the runtime, you'll be see, you can see that value will be prevailing at the current state, and you can turn it again, that will be running from the current state. So that is the retention. Even if the power is failure or we are fixing a power failure, that won't be a trouble for the retentive timers. And we are going to the off timer. I'm changing it to off timer and I'm removing the retention and apply. Then I'm going to the runtime. And again, start the controller. And now it's the off timer, so I have to put it on first. And now you can see the output is already on the when I'm on, but the timer is not running, the preset value is still 0. And I'm making it off. You can see we'll be getting the output for 10 seconds more. That is the off delay timer. After 10 seconds, that will be automatically turns off the supply. That is the off delay timer. After on and off, we will be getting the power. And let's see the difference between off timer and the pulse timer. I'm making it as a pulse timer, TP, and apply and run. And we hit the run. And I'm just making a pulse. I'm just giving a pulse on and off. You can see when it is on and off, we'll be getting a power, or we'll be getting the supply for 10 seconds. We'll be getting the output for 10 seconds. That is a pulse timer. We'll just need a one pulse for the entire operation. So get back and we'll be hitting the counters. Deleting this and I'm placing the counters right here. You can see the counter right here. And placing the counter. There's a reset, set, counter, countdown. And done it also. And you can see the down count overflow, and here we will be getting the up count overflow as E and F. And I'm just placing 3 contacts more and 3 coils also. By placing 3 coils, I'll be getting the outputs. So I'm just making my counter as percentage clicking and the preset as 5 counts. 5. And apply. So my file will be my preset, and percentage C0.V will be showing the current value. C0.V and enter will be getting the C0.V, and we can address the inputs like percentage I0.1, percentage I0.2, and percentage I0.3, and the outputs as percentage Q0.1, percentage Q0.2, and we can go to hit the runtime right now. I'll go into runtime. You can see all the things, and I'm going to give some counts by giving the up counting. I0.2 will be the up counting bit. I'm using the I0.2 right here. By pressing 1, you can see the current value of the counter as 1 on and off. By changing the counter on and off, you can see the timer, sorry, the counter value will be increasing. When the it is reaching the preset of 5, that will be giving the output of the done bit, or the up count reaches the preset value, you will be getting the output while reaching the 5 preset value. So I'm going to reset this. I'm going to reset this. I'm using the I0.0 input for resetting. By pressing the or toggling the reset, you can see the current value becomes 0. And we can, I'm going to use the set next. Set we are using for getting the accumulator or the current value reaches the preset at a single tap or a single toggle. That is the set. And I'm going to reset it again. Then I'm going to down count now. Okay, let's see what if I am down counting from 0. So I'm using the I0.3 for down counting, and you can see there we will be getting the down count overflow. It is down counting from 0, so it will be reaching the value of 9999. So it'll be getting the down counting overflow, and I'm going to up counting from the 9999. So we'll be getting the up count overflow. So the total value, it will be 10,000. That's why 0 to 9999 will be getting the range of the counter. So up count and down count we can do in this counter, and we'll be getting the done bit by percentage C0.D. That is the done bit. And hope you enjoyed timers and counters and basics, and stay tuned for the new videos, and thank you. Thanks for watching.